welcome, Philip.
Hello, my name is Philip. I'm a loving father. Oh, Nadia. By the way. I'm a loving father of two wonderful cheeky kids. Husband to wife, she's cheeky too. And I'm a proud, adoring partner of three hairy guinea pigs. So my life is quite hard to organize. In my professional life, I'm an organizational consultant and mediator working in the field of development cooperation. Who else here is working in this field? Show up. Yeah, together we make the world a better place. Yes. Woo. So, you know what I do as an organization consultant. I help people like many of you to better structure your work so that you can help people in less developed countries to better structure their work. Quite a tricky impact chain, isn't it? As a proud German organizational consultant, I define efficient work plans, organizational structures, and I empower people. I love it when I see them grow. So I empower them and they grow. I empower them and they grow and they grow and they grow and they grow until they become giants. When I have to shrink them again. Because, sorry, but being a giant is not efficient. One challenge about being an organizational consultant is that I'm not at all well organized myself. From time to time, a little tiny email gets lost in the wide universe called my personal inbox. For example, I received an email from Damaris yesterday. She wrote me, "Hello, Philip. I invited you to a Skype call, but you didn't show up. I've been waiting for you more than 5 hours, and it's already the 6th time you didn't show up. Please start organizing your life. Not so warm regards, Damaris." Another example, worse example even, my travel expense accounting. It's what a mess. Imagine one table full of travel receipts. I pick out one. Oh, this taxi receipt from July 2016. Which trip was it again? Can't figure it out. Let's call it a day. I subsidized the GSZ more than 10,000 euros over the past years, I think. So it's quite expensive being an unorganized organizational consultant that is traveling a lot. Very often conflict is part of the process. People love to argue. They prefer being misunderstood than to be understood. Do you know this? It's weird, isn't it? But their conflict, I mean, it's fine for me, because it keeps me busy as a mediator. So I invite them to share their positions, their interests, their needs. Do you know the iceberg model? Do you know it? Yes. It's a model that helps people to discover the underwater part of their personal iceberg, where the needs are, where we can find the common ground. So together with my clients, we dig deeper and deeper and deeper into the iceberg until the whole iceberg is melted in love. Luckily, in my private life, I can mostly avoid conflicts. I'm more cool and relaxed, so to say, the nature and adventure type guy. I'm sure you have noticed already my muscles and my athletic physique. Climbing, surfing, merging with the elements, I do it all. People love it, especially women. At the moment, it's all this outdoor adventure activity is more in my head. So I'm more, so to say, in the preparation phase, I would say. Yeah. It's like I tell my clients, you better plan your adventures. Otherwise, they become real adventures. For example, I recently bought one of these expedition sleeping bags, model polar bear. I need it. It keeps me warm and cozy in temperatures of down to minus 30 degrees. I could even, thanks to this amazing sleeping bag, I could even sleep on the top of my iceberg and stay warm and cozy. Or I also bought one of these huge, masculine, silver hunting knives, which I need all of my muscles just to lift it. I bought it in case I could meet an 8-foot polar bear. Or another adventure guy. You never know who you meet out there in the wilderness of my backyard in Oberhöchstadt. Next summer I'm going to try out all my survival equipment, my hunting knife and the sleeping bag at a 5-star fancy glittering camping place at Ibiza. We're going to have an intimate alone time together, my wife, our 2 kids, and my 3 hairy girlfriends, our guinea pigs. Yes, these 3 girlfriends, they're not classical attractive, I would say. They're a bit hairy, rather stinky, and they all have bad teeth. There are no invisible liners for guinea pigs yet on the market. Not attractive, but their personalities are outstanding. One likes to fool around, one sleeps whole day, and the third, she squeals every time she sees me. Quick, quick! Which means hello, darling, in guinea pig language. My triple guinea pig love affair started when our kids wanted to have pets. Please, daddy, please, please, can we have, we need cute animals, please, be a good daddy. That hurt. It went straight to my heart. Of course I want to be a good daddy. But on the other hand, I'm strongly allergic against everything that moves. I mean, what shall I do? The only animals I'm not allergic to are horses, dolphins, and elephants. Every kid's dream, but too huge for our flat. So that's why we chose guinea pigs, because you can keep them outside. Which is good for me and my allergies, but bad for them when it becomes cold. So you know what's happening now, huh? Winter came and they started begging. Please let us in. Please, Philip. Please be a good partner. I first offered them my polar sleeping bag, but they refused. Hey, jerk, don't you know that this sleeping bag is much too big for us little guinea pigs? So we had no choice. My family and I, we invited them to live with us in the flat. We're now, my wife and I, we're now sharing our parental bedroom with them. Simple like this, care led to affection, affection led to love, and love led to cohabitation. There's only one little thing that bothers me, their hairy legs. I even considered once to buy them an epilator. But I gave up the idea. I gave it up, the idea, quite fast. Because me, the image of me helping them to shave their tiny little legs was not enticing. So I decided to leave them hairy and proud and to never touch again their legs. As an organizational consultant, I know you should not mix up life areas. Body hygiene here and Romans there. It demands all of my mediation skills to integrate them into family life, because there are tensions. Daddy, they ate all my cereals. Daddy, they peed on my bed. Honey, I think they used my shaving cream again. So to create peace, I use my professional skills as mediator. I gather them all, my wife, our two kids, and the three guinea pigs, and me, in our living room. We sit on the carpet, because the guinea pigs, they refuse to sit at the table. And we share our positions, interests, and needs. There are huge differences. Okay. For example, my wife, she likes the flat clean, whereas the guinea pigs love living in the total mess. But there's also one huge common ground. We all believe in love. And we like it warm and cozy. So maybe my private and my professional life aren't that different after all. Thank you and good night. Woo!